metatarsal phalangeal and interphalangeal joint range of motion. You need to stabilize the proximal bone and move the distal bone. So for the metatarsal phalangeal, you need to stabilize the first metatarsal bone and move from the phalanx into flexion and extension through the available range. For the interphalangeal joint, stabilize the proximal phalanx and move the distal phalanx through the available range of flexion and extension. You can apply the same for the rest of the toes.